Hello and welcome to another replay cast, and this time I'm featuring Jake from this Dead Farm. That's probably his name. He's playing in the tier 9 battleship the Alsace, and oh sorry, I think the speed was a bit too high. He's playing on the map Hotspot, has a favorable matchmaking, means tier 9 to tier 7. So I referred to it quite a while ago, and I'm keeping off emphasizing it. If you are top tier, it's expected that you carry at least, or that you throw in your HP and not sit at the first line back and or do some other shenanigans which don't help the team. So the fact that he spotted and he knows that there is a DD probably approaching into D. He's getting shot at, what I don't like, because you show too much broadside. You always want to bring your third gun to bear, I understand that, but usually the ships are moving from here to this area, and then eventually here or whatever. So they have full broadside on you here, so you lose. I mean, in this case, it didn't matter. Now you're even in cover and not spotted anymore, but it can happen that you, especially in a tier 10 game, you can get a really massive hit, and that could lose your HP without any necessity, in my opinion. But it's just a minor thing. As we see, his main, the most of his team are at A, and he does not know what is coming around here. There's no ship spotted, and you are only like 3 ships here, so I would consider playing careful. What you're doing right now is like, sometimes I don't get it. Sometimes in a stationary cruiser, okay, but if you want to go aggressive here, you want to take a wide approach, then you can see at least what kind of ships you are heading to. If you like go like this, then you see it only at this edge, and there could be a destroyer, there could be whatever, a cruiser like Hindenburg or whatever. I mean, it's tier 7, but still, can be a fucking nasty surprise for you, on the other hand. So now you know at least, okay, there are some ships. Miyoko, that's not a big issue. What I like is that you immediately turn away as soon as you see how many ships are approaching. That's a good point. You lose some HP, maybe unnecessary, but still okay. You turn away, angle away, let your secondaries work, and you try to bring most of your guns on the target, or like all the guns, which is always recommended if you don't lose HP for it. And in this case, you are angled towards the Nagato, you won't necessarily lose anything. Okay, Nagato, I think you turn, I mean, I saw that replay now the second time. I think you show a bit too much broadside when it isn't necessary. Just do it when your guns are loaded, and then you turn in, or you wait for the shots of the enemy. Yeah, I was just about to say that probably the Miyoko talked to you, but yeah, nevertheless. I think you're doing pretty fine. That Nagato is way too aggressive. Nagato is not a brawler at all. You should have turned as soon as you shot the Miyoko. You should have turned away, because that's a fight you never will win in a Nagato. Alsace 380mm guns will just overmatch it everywhere. It has only 25mm bow, and even though he has like 410mm guns, the same like the Magi, I think, with a bit less penetration. It still can't overmatch you, so there's actually no harm. I like the Nagato, but in this case, this is just a fight you can't win. And that's what I mean, you show just simply too much broadside. I mean, I understand that you wanna bring all your secondaries to bear, but I think you lose some HP a bit too unnecessary. Especially, I mean, I know what's happening, but in the late game you wanna have as much HP as possible, so means you don't have to play ineffective before. But here, the same. Wait for the, yeah, exactly. You just turned in too early, because the Nagato could have shot you out. He was not dead. And yeah, now you're doing exactly the same to the Tirpitz just to shoot the North Carolina. So I'm not a big fan of that, because you lost a lot of HP for absolutely no reason. Yeah, North Carolina is giving way too much broadside here. So now you should turn northwards. You don't want to go in a brawl with the Tirpitz. Yeah, I think you're a bit too focused there on this NC. Okay, so, but now you should turn away. Your secondaries are doing fine anyway, so no necessity to show too much broadside all the way. Another big hit. So you lose, I mean, let's face it, you play 1v4, this is fine. But still, if you want to carry games, keep as much HP as possible. Okay, so if you are angled, this Tirpitz can't do much to you. Don't turn in, don't show too much broadside. The thing is, you want to wait for your guns to turn. I think you're okay-ish angled. Could be a bit better. I think you're way too focused on the secondaries here. I mean, it's a lot of fun, I know. But, yeah. At least you are doing what I refer to, that you are playing what you are expected to do. So, being the punching bag for the enemy team by not dying too quickly. That's definitely a thing that I can absolutely support, and I'm a big fan of. It's good. Turn in your ass. Maybe you wanna juke off the torps, you might think. I'm not sure. Some of your secondary guns are dead, or I don't know. Yeah, that was a good angling. That was perfect angling. So at that angling, you should maintain. You're doing exactly the same what a lot of players do, or tend to do, which is when they have full HP, they are playing a bit careless, and when they aren't, when they have lower HP, they play as they are supposed to play, usually, if you want to play optimal. So yeah, also, you're kind of this show-off buddy, I guess. So, well, okay, you did a good job there with 1v4. Nothing to complain, and it's fine. But, as I said, and it sticks, you have no heal left. And, yeah, it might come in handy sooner or later. But yeah, let's see. So, and now you go back towards D, I guess. You need definitely caps, that's for sure. Yeah, you're behind in points, but ahead in ships. Yeah, it's definitely doable. But imagine you had like half a, HP now. That would be way more comfortable, I would say. Oh, that's Fletcher versus Akatsuki. This is nasty. Even though... Akatsuki, ha! What is this Fletcher doing? Oh my. He misses all the torps. Great play there by the Akatsuki. I think he slowed down, juked him. Normally, these Japanese CD players tend to die to everything somehow, but this guy, he will play a role later on in the game, we will see it. Yeah, was actually good. Good play. Yeah, some of your secondaries got destroyed. Yeah, just saw it there. That's the thing the French secondaries or the secondaries on French battleships tend to do. They are not really well armored and are taken out pretty easily compared to, for example, the German secondaries. They are way more durable. But yeah, that is how it is, right? So at A, it's kind of these games. I mean, you stop the whole push on the one side, while your Cleveland, your Tirpitz also died in the decap, and at A it was also, I think the majority of your team went there, but still couldn't manage to get it. Yeah, highly questionable, but looks like a weak end game to me. Oh yeah, I just saw you actually gather already 250,000 damage. Well, you fought three battleships and one cruiser. No surprise. Yeah, the Alsace is a pretty ship, I can agree. That's for sure. So, it's a bit of an issue if you sit there on one flank, but there's nothing, no critics in it. You need some time to come back, be in the game again. But luckily, you have speed boost, which is fine. So what I would do is now, since you have no real health left, what I would have done was like sitting myself probably in here, concealed or hidden behind an island, and support whatever is going on here. That's one option. The other one would be stay concealed as long as possible. Try not to end in a crossfire. So what you could do is actually go ham on this Iowa here by shooting the Atlanta, because Missouri is handling the Lion. Or handling, hopefully is handling. So you go for the Iowa. Full speed ahead and just go for ramming speed to take him out. Okay, he's going in there. That's interesting. Yeah, shooting the Atlanta is probably the best target. If you take him out, the Akatsuki is pretty safe. Wow, that Lion is full HP. That might get iffy here. And watch out that you don't show too much broadside towards the Iowa. And let your secondary work on the Lion, which is okay, but turn in. If the Iowa has some awareness, he's shooting you. Or eventually you can also ram the Lion. I mean, depends. But I would definitely go for a ram here. You have, especially the target that you want to face the least is the Lion, because he has these HE volleys that just devastates you. So in that case, probably the best idea would go for the Lion. Seems as if your Missouri has big trouble with him. Yeah, you should go for the ram on the Lion. That secures definitely the win. And you still tend to show a bit too much broadside. Okay, Lion is shooting HE. But now you have the speed boost, so you're way more maneuverable than the Lion, and he might not be able to evade it. If he gets another volley off you, that's a bit of an issue. I think you reacted a bit too slow. Yeah, two fires. Yeah. If you would have gone now full speed, you might really might have stand a chance. Yeah, now you're going down. That's iffy. I mean, Missouri dead, you dead. Yeah, I think you didn't think it through completely. I mean, mostly well played by you, but there are these minor things, what you could do better, in my opinion. I mean, not to mention that you did quite a lot already, but if you wanna win 100 for 100%, you always wanna do the right decisions, or you have to do them at least. Yeah, but your Akatsuki is doing quite well. Almost took out the Iowa. Yeah, but your Missouri is just simply going down now. So, you are behind in points, but you have three caps. I think a kill is necessary. So you can just hope for the Akatsuki, who's, I don't know if it's widespread or narrow spread. Hopefully not widespread. But okay, I think one torp hit on each ship will seal the deal. So if the Akatsuki is going a bit closer, I think he might pull this off. And then he would be the other big hero of the game after you did your job there on the 9-10 line. Then should be fine, I think. Tops look okay-ish. Line activated the monster heal. Okay, Lion is not a one shot anymore. Don't know if that is widespread or narrow spread. Looks narrow spread to me. Oh, Mr. Lion, you eat two torps. Well, that's good for your team. So that means one torp hit. Oh no, the Iowa repaired as well. You need a kill. Without kill, you won't win. That's for sure. So if they secure B and run away, and then your team will lose. Yeah, Akatsuki has AA on. I just saw it a bit. He was probably spotted, so he waits hopefully for his torps. I mean, Akatsuki has a pretty fast torp reload, but now these torps need count really much. So he sees they are turning around, so hopefully he's getting the right aim. Going a bit closer. And now all the hope lies in the top volley of the Akatsuki. Doesn't look too bad that Iowa might get hit if he doesn't react properly. And that Iowa, look at the guns from the Iowa. He has literally no clue where the DD is. Oh, was that the no camo Akatsuki? That's even crazier. And Iowa got killed. That's the win. Wow. Amazing. Yeah, two heroes here. Jack from the stats farm and Imperial Japanese Navy. All right, yeah. Thanks for sending this in. No result screens, but I guess that was kind of a good amount of basics. Probably 2,500 around. Yeah. Hope you learn from the critics I gave you. Apart from that, nice game. Definitely enjoyable to watch and a lot of secondary fun. Yeah. So, what can I say? If you liked it, give it a like. And yeah, have a nice day and see you next time. Bye bye.